How's your summer going? Spend a lot of time in the pool? It's hot. Fond memories, the old swimming hole. Well, let me retroactively ruin them. Pools are gross. The thing about water is that pathogens actually thrive in it, some of them. Harmful viruses, bacteria, and protozoa can be transmitted from one person to another by way of pool water. Over 14 years, health officials from 46 states in Puerto Rico reported almost 500 outbreaks linked to treated recreational water, causing more than 27,000 illnesses and 8 deaths. Since many people don't go to a doctor when they're sick and it's difficult to actually test water for contaminants after an outbreak, those numbers could actually be higher still. Now, you may be thinking that a lot of these outbreaks were caused by pools that probably weren't treated properly. And it's true that that does happen remarkably often. A 2016 CDC study found 80% of public pools had health and safety violations. 80%! 1 in 8 facilities failed their inspections so badly that they were closed immediately. Undertreated pools can lead to tragedy, like in 1998 when 7 swimmers who shared a pool with a child with E. coli were hospitalized. That resulted in 1 death. E. coli outbreaks like that can be prevented by properly treating pools with our old dear friend, chlorine. The chlorine that's added to pools comes in either the form of hypochlorous acid or hypochlorite ions, and it reacts with the lipids in a microorganism cell wall or enzymes inside the cells and kills them, and this is good. But chlorine also reacts with ammonia in things like sweat and urine. This results in chloramines, which are responsible for the pool smell. It also means that there's less free chlorine available to kill friggin' E. coli, and that's bad. Yeah, that's right. Chlorine smell and your red irritated eyes actually mean that a pool is underchlorinated, not overchlorinated. A properly treated pool has no smell. Yeah, none. But even if a pool is chlorinated, some pathogens can survive, like cryptosporidium. This single-celled parasite has an outer shell that makes it resistant to chlorine. It's the leading cause of waterborne disease in the United States, and symptoms include abdominal pain, fever, nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. And that last symptom is also bad for poolgoers. Diarrhea is almost always caused by some infectious microorganism, and people can spread it in pools up to 2 weeks after the symptoms subside. Then all it takes is for another swimmer to inadvertently swallow some infected pool water and start the cycle anew. Even if people haven't had diarrhea, they can still shed poop and its associated pathogens into the pool. One study found that the average person, that is you, me, anybody, has 0.14 grams of poop on our stinky bumps. That's about the weight of a pea, a pea's worth of poop. I love that I get paid to say this stuff. Fortunately, it's actually not hard to avoid becoming a disease vector. How many people don't shower before getting in a pool because they figure the pool will wash them off? Yeah, it's a lot of us. It turns out we were all wrong. Showering before swimming is a good way to clean up our gross butts for everyone's benefit, and it also washes away sweat. So if you remember, the chlorine won't react with it. I can't believe I have to say this, but you should also avoid peeing in the pool. One survey found that 1 out of 5 people admit to peeing in pools, while I just assume the other 4 people are lying. Pee also has ammonia in it that will use up free chlorine, making the pool smell bad and be less safe. So, in the end, avoid swallowing the water as best you can. And lastly, if you've had diarrhea in the last 2 weeks, just do us a favor, put on some sunblock and lay by the pool. Read a book. The rest of us will then enjoy a cryptosporidium-free pool time. Have a great summer, everyone. Not all microbes are bad. For example, your gut is filled with microbes. They're just controlling your mind. No big deal. Watch Marin's video here to understand how. And one last thing, I don't actually have a cool fun fact for you, but you ever thought about how often we empty pools and just like scrub them down? Maybe actually don't think about it. And thanks for watching, Seeker.